Okay, it's Friday, August 24th or 5th, whatever day it is, the last Friday of August 2018. And I'm out here at the garden and just going to check the okra because we've been cutting it. And we'll let it go a day or two and then it's a lot of okra in here. But temperatures today are cool. There's some small buds on there, you can see. But overall, there might be about three or four on here. There's one long one I see. I don't know if you can see it on there right in the middle. There's one right there. That's about five inches long. I'll get that one in a minute, but just showing you how it's just the small ones right there. There's one on the right and smaller one on the left there. Smaller right there. Right there. And like I said, there's a small the one right there is about 2 inches. And it's overcast. It's supposed to be only up around 84 today. See, but if you look down there on the bottom, you look at that big red one. Where's that? Right there. There's one, the one touching the plastic is about 7 inches long. The one on top there is about 4.5, maybe 5 inches. Getting in here is going to be more dangerous. Not dangerous, but it's going to get itchy. You get on the okra plants, it gets on your arms and you start itching. They're too close. I made it too close. I put too much in here. This basil is supposed to help with insects and all that, but it does to a point, but not always so great. There's a red one right there in the middle. It's about 3 inches. So, you know, it's just, I brought this out here. Sometimes we fill this up halfway full. Before we were filling like two of these a day. Now we're getting maybe a total of one in 2 days. But the zucchini, all this has been left like this, kind of like natural, we let it just die down, but see, I got plastic down here. All those seeds down there are for zucchini. And next year they'd probably grow up here, but this is where I'm gonna put hopefully 4 to 8 tomatoes here next year. You know, and then a couple peppers, which that one down there is growing. It hadn't been doing anything all year. Like I said, now look at it. I mean, we usually have grow all the way through about the middle to end of November. So we still might get some green bell peppers off of that one. That stake coming up out of it is about 24 inches tall. So that's about 4 inches, 5 inches tall out of the ground. There was another one, but it's died off. This torch sunflower got knocked over somehow or another. Again, miraculous, everything just falls over by itself. Although we've had bad winds, but just not recently. That's why I don't understand why this one's all knocked over. This brings the butterflies, hummingbirds, and honeybees, which are still out here. These beans are being picked over pretty good. I got about, there might be about 5, 6, 7, 8 pods of purple hull peas on these last back ones here. And the black-eyed peas right here. You see the leaves, how they get all diseased. You know, get these beans off of here today and tomorrow. Probably today, because it's going to get real hot tomorrow. Supposed to get into 91. I don't know what this stuff is. If anybody does, it'd be nice if they'd comment about it. I know that's purslane. That's natural, too. It's real healthy for you, too, by the way. That and that right there, that just grows naturally. It just came up. We didn't plant that, but it came up. We didn't plant any of this stuff. But it's coming up. I've taken a couple of those little round leaves off and eating it. It's really bad tasting, but it's really healthy for you. But just to make note that. See, nothing over here just came up with anything. I don't know what we're going to put over here next year. Tomatoes and some peppers over there. We're not going to do like we did this year either with the watermelon. Went from the southwest corner and came all the way over here to the tomatoes, which is more than 2/3 of this garden. Almost 3/4 of it. And the tomatoes got swamped, and now because of that, the worms got in here and the insects and all that. And look at this one. It's a cherry tomato, cherry tomato, cherry tomato, cherry tomato. And the thing is, I didn't even realize I planted cherry tomatoes. I was trying to get all bigger tomato plants out here. And the ones that weren't doing so good now at the end of the year are starting to come up. But at the same token, I don't know if you know, it's heirloom tomatoes, but look at the green. Look at how it looks. Spotty almost. And that might be the type of heirloom tomato it is. You know, because these others aren't like that. None of these others are like that. Just this one here. So it might be the type of tomato that this is. It's an heirloom tomato. All this stuff is heirloom, but I'm saying, look at the stripes, like, or whatever you want to call it. I can't get the camera. I can't hold the camera and do this. You see all the lines on here, like, it's like it's a certain type of tomato. You know, it's not a disease or anything. That I know for a fact. It would look a little different if it was a disease. And see, here's another pepper plant that came out here. That one's doing good too. That's about 6 inches, 7 inches tall. This one might put out a couple, you know, 4 or 5 peppers by November. Same one with the one over there by the okra. Yeah, see, it's not focusing real easy. That one down there, if you can see it on the bottom, middle, right there. But this is a late one that's coming out through these tomatoes. But see, look at this. I can't be out here with my knees being as bad as they've been worse this year. Every year it seems like they're getting worse. But you see that? That's no good. I take that off. I throw this in this Monsanto food-like product corn over here. Let's see. All right, down there. Evidently, Mr. Thomas has been out here and bush hogged. Because we had shown cantaloupes that were over here. Right in that area right there was cantaloupes, a big swath right in here. Started with watermelon, cantaloupe, and cucumber, and then cantaloupe, and honeydew. And now, see, like right here's a squash bug. See that one running? Watch this. I just squashed them too. That's what you do with squash bugs. But this was all cantaloupe and honeydew. And my wife tore them up and just threw them into the outskirts over here. And Mr. Thomas is bush hogged over here. You can see the clearing there. And she threw some cantaloupe and honeydews and vines over in here. And he probably just bush hogged right over it. Which is all part of nature. But beginning of the season, this wide swath right here is where they sprayed their Roundup. Oh, it's not Roundup. Yeah, it's Roundup, okay, folks? It was Roundup. And that's why these sunflowers didn't do so good at all. I mean, these others come back. I planted several times, too. There should be a good solid wall here of sunflowers, but you can see how they look. I went right there, and I went on an angle, and then I went along the east end over there. Everything on the north end and starting to go back that way, it was dead and dying off until I planted more and more and more. So next year, I'm going to plant sunflowers, but I'm going to come about 10 feet south. I mean, 10 feet north of the garden. This is the north end over here anyway. South end's over there. So I'm about 10 feet back here. Year before last I had, you can almost see the line where I had planted sunflowers last year. I'm going to try to get out here with a stick or a tomato stake and a string. I'm going to put it 10 feet off of the plastic over there back, 10 feet from there over there, and 10 feet in the middle. And then I'm just going to put a string through there. And that's where I'm going to till it up and try to put nothing but sunflowers back here. Been doing this for like 6 years. And each year it just starts to get better. This was going to be a decent one until they sprayed that stuff. You know, I was going to have a good sunflower wall right there. I've had better than this year, big time. But this was going to be a real good one. I put a lot of sunflowers there. Even that orange one you can see. It's a torch sunflower. I was going to have about 5 or 6 torch sunflowers spread out. Which is kind of like that bush you see. Like these right here. These are all torch sunflowers with the orange flowers. That was going to block between the Monsanto crap and my garden. So that would have been right back here. But again, they sprayed that Monsanto crap Roundup. Because, you know, that stuff right there, it's not even food, folks. Well, that right there is for feed. It's for animals. They're going to feed animals that. And then you're going to eat the animal. There you go. It's called evolution. But there's a pepper plant right there. This one hasn't been, nothing's been done to this one. I usually put them out here and I let them go. But some of these I've actually used Proto-Grow and tried to keep them going. That one's one. But it's late in the year and it's kind of, like I say, it's only going to be up to about 84 today. These cucumbers are going to get pulled up probably Sunday. There should be a big one, my wife said, down here. You want it to go yellow and get seeds from it, but again, you see these, what I call my poor man fences, because, you know, when the poop hits the fan, you're not going to be able to go to the store and get this and get that. You got to make do as best you can, so that's what I've been trying to do. Tomato steaks and chicken wire, or not chicken wire, it's fencing. That's 3 by 5 inch fencing, or 3 by 4 inch fencing. I got some chicken wire, I thought, somewhere out here, too, but I don't know where I put it. But anyway, I used the tomato steaks and fencing that. It was like 36 inches and I cut it in half, and then I do half and half. But see, I use tomato stakes and fencing, did my own fencing, because, you know, when you can't go to the store and buy fencing, what are you going to do? Use what you got, unless you got the money to have the wood to make your own fences, which I don't. I make do with what I have. Got two. Set that pan down. Okay, I got two beans. There's a good healthy one there, and that one there, for some reason, seems stunted, the one next to it. We got same thing here. We got one here, and the one on the outside is stunted. So just looking at the healthy ones, we got two there, the small one. Three, four, five, six. Six out of eight in the first section. Here, we got one here and one coming up. Nothing else, which, you know, is unusual. Here, same thing. One coming up. Got another one down there with no leaves yet. Over here, and as you go forward, I have four holes in three rows here. Two seeds in each one, so there should be eight in each row. Got one coming up. That's it. Just starting. And you got two right there. And the fencing to go north. Then over here, all these are coming up. There's two down there. Four, six, eight. So I got that over because of the cucumbers here. I kind of moved the fencing over. I want to put this more this way, you know, but I can't put that there. I just left it. And here, I didn't even know if I planted, but evidently I did, because I see a beam right there coming up. And I see one coming out of the soil down there. So I hear the hummer just right by my ear over here by these torch sunflowers. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I want to have 8, 9, maybe even 10 rows. And if you have 8 beans in each one, that's 80 bean plants, you know. So, and back here I have purple hull peas. This is just beyond the halfway point going north. Purple hull pea. Oh, wow. See, I put two. I thought I put two in each hole, but here I got three growing. There's two on the left there and one on the right. These are purple hull peas. Black-eyed peas, I need to plant some of those before it gets much later, probably even this weekend. It's going to be hot. So tomorrow morning, you see, now look, you see how small that pepper plant is right there? That's about 2 inches above the ground. That's how they've all been all summer, all summer. So that one there all of a sudden came up a little bit. You know, but the one by the tomatoes over here is the one that got so big. And I said, hopefully we'll get some peppers off of this one, at least green peppers. You can freeze that. See right there? That's a green pepper plant. And see, like this stuff here, this is diseased. Thanks to these beautiful, I've got a pin oak and a black oak right here. And that is not an oak, I don't know what that is. And this is just a couple, three trees grown together, which is crap. All 1, 2, 3, I'm going to say 5 because there should be 2 there. So 5 trees here all have brown spot. And they're about 25 feet off the garden. And you see leaves all over the plastic, which I had. You know, with my bad knees and not being able to do this so well, being overweight, I'm killing all these squash because you're stepping on them. I'm just squashing them like that, see? But with the, you know, these brown spot, these trees with the brown spot on here, the leaves get all over the plastic. And if I keep zooming in, you see them inside the holes here. They get on the leaves, and then that's the result. That's another one of the tomatoes that's coming out late, the tomato plant. I can't be out here with my knees, like I said, but I was trimming the lower branches. You can cut off the lower branches. I can't do it with the camera in my hand. Break off these lower branches, because, you know, nothing's going to grow from them. You got all these up here that are healthy. This one, too. This is one of the late ones, but see, it's got brown spot already on it. See all the yellow and brown spot? It's got a couple tomatoes on there. And, oh, there's the third one. And by the house is where that one that we didn't plant it, but we got three by the back of the house, and there's a couple up by the front on the side that just are growing. See, I got to pick up these yellow tomatoes that are turning before they get all messed up. But look at this. See, this is healthy. But then look down there, all the yellow and brown. You know. Like I said, I'd like to have about 6 or 8 in the front garden, number one garden. This is the number three garden. It goes 65 feet from west to east, and it's about 34 feet from south to north. But there's my purple hull peas, like I said, purple hull peas. And I want to try getting two more rows, I think I'll do over here. Because, you know, your beans, you put them in bags and, you know, dry beans. I don't really care so much of the ones with the, like, green beans or string beans, if you call them. I prefer the bean, the pea. So I'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 different spots here would be growing beans. And if they all grew, it'd be, you know, a lot. But it'd still be pretty good, I think. I think there's 26 or 27 plants that are coming up right now. But see, that's counting the small ones, too. Come on, this is a Sony camera, it won't even focus good. Down there, the one on the right. Looks like it's bent over right there. See, and there's a couple like that, but that's counting as 27, or 26 or 27. But every time I walk, I guess I see a squash bug, and I just go in and I squash them. But of actual beans, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I see 19 beans up right now. And then the peas in the back, there's 4. So, come October, we'll be out here picking all this stuff off. I don't think we're going to get any eggplant because of, you know, the brown spot. You know, I don't put chemicals on this stuff either, by the way. Baking soda and water for diseases, which has helped in the past. And Epsom salt. Sugar, water, that's like for your tomatoes and peppers. But yeah, see there's some flowers on this one now. You can see. And they had closed up before. There's 1, 2. There's about 3, 4 flowers on there right now. That's where you have some eggplants. Last year we had some that were about the size of almost the size of a 12-inch softball. So this little bit of cucumber right here is going to get pulled up here. Probably Sunday. Might let it go to Monday, but that's it. And then this one will be nothing but beans over here. So, number 3 garden from the west going east will be all beans. Let the tomatoes grow as much as possible. That one pepper plant over there. Where's the other pepper plant? That one back there in the back. And then the one up in the number 1 garden. Oh, boy. Yeah, like I said, I was going to cut off okra, but there's only about 3 or 4, and it's not worth the trouble to do it right now. Later this afternoon, come back here. Because you can see these, how small these are still. That's about 2 inches, inch and a half. No, they're small, so. The elderberry, next year, everybody's saying the first year won't be good. Well, they said it might not be, and it hasn't been because we had insects all over them, but I got some elderberries on there. You got 2 plants to get them. This one here primarily has the berries, the other one doesn't, so. Let them grow out here. Get that wind thing away from that windmill, whatever you want to call it. I get my sunflower seeds here end of a couple weeks too, on November. I like to leave these out here for the birds right now, and then I get some to just keep regrowing this stuff forever because it's heirloom. So crap you buy at China Mart, you got a 50-50 shot. Some of it will grow second year maybe, third year probably not. This will grow forever as long as you plant the seeds from the plant. So, that's it. Hopefully this one will come up. Maybe by the end of September, that'll be the 24 inches as high as that little broken tomato stake there. That's cleaned up, you know, picked up and put in that burn barrel and burned. So, yeah, it's just going to be like 3 okra over here. Now we're here, but 3 okra and 2 zucchinis next year. It might be over there even. But tomatoes, between 4 and 8 tomato plants and pepper plants in number 1 garden right here. That's all.